And the weekend is just upon us, and that means maybe taking in a movie would be a good idea for you.
Toledo Free Press film editor James A. Molnar takes a look at the amazing Spider-Man 2. Morning, James.
Good morning, guys. How are you?
Good.
Thirsty Friday.
I guess so. Did either of you see the first Spider-Man?
Years ago, right?
It was 2 years ago for the relaunch of Spider-Man.
Oh, no. I did the one with Kirsten Dunst, isn't that her name?
And Tobey Maguire. Yeah,
all right, yes. Well, that was just over 12 years ago.
Oh, no. James!
But they've relaunched it.
You can't do this to me. You made me feel...
Well, that was back when you were in college, right?
No!
Or high school?
Yeah, maybe. High school.
Well, the
never give away a woman's age, all right, James?
I didn't. I'm trying
to... You're going to dig yourself in a hole here.
All right, well, let's get out of the hole. And it's time for the summer blockbuster season. It's upon us, and this amazing Spider-Man 2 is in theaters. We have not Kristen Dunst, but we have Emma Stone and Andrew Garfield.
Mm-hmm. Are they dating?
They are dating in real life, and that makes the chemistry in this movie perfect. And there aren't too many hot scenes. It's PG-13, so we keep it good for the kids. Not too frisky on this Friday for them. And as you see, we have some new villains in the movie, one played by Jamie Foxx, Electro, almost reminiscent of the Emperor in Star Wars, kind of. And fun times with this movie. I really loved this, the first part of this movie 2 years ago when it came out. Mm-hmm. Mark Webb, new director, really putting the fun back in Spider-Man, not so dark and ominous.
Yeah, I do have a question about this though. So for people who did see some of the earlier versions, is this something completely different, totally different villains, totally different girlfriend, or are they pretending it's the same?
It is a little bit different. There you have Sally Field as Aunt May, wonderful role, one of my favorite roles in the movie. And this one, there are very similar plot points with the old trilogy and this new trilogy, but I would say it's a lot more fun. The acting is a lot better in this series, and they're just a little bit different. So I definitely love this trilogy more, and if you do at home, there are more to come. Sony has already greenlit two more sequels to this movie in 2016 and 2018, so Spider-Man is not going anywhere.
So this is the start of a new trilogy. Now, if you're a little fuzzy on the details of what's unfolded in the past, because it's maybe been 10 years since you've seen one of the movies, can you pick right back up with this?
I would recommend watching the first Spider-Man, The Amazing Spider-Man, that came out 2 years ago. I'd rent that on DVD before you see this, just because there are a lot of plot points in this movie that refer back to that first movie.
Okay.
So I'm giving this 4 out of 5 stars.
Whoa, James.
Really enjoyed it.
That's Frisky really Friday. Up your chart. The highest I've seen him go is 3.
Well, it's hard.
Five. This, a five.
Yeah, but this, you know, we're finally getting into some good movies of the year. So I'm happy to dole out more stars if the movies are better. So
there you go. We like your honesty.
The first Amazing Spider-Man, I gave 5 out of 5 stars. So this one is not quite as good. But if you didn't like the first one, give this one a shot. You may like this one more.
Well, if you saw the Scream movies, also probably 15 years ago at this time, they always say that the sequel is never as good as the original.
It just depends on the movie, but that's true in this case.
All right, James, thank you so much. Appreciate
no problem.
You coming in. Have a great weekend.
You too.